Up, Jesus followers, and welcome back to another Sunday night service. We are so glad you're tuning in today. Before we get into service, I got three quick announcements that I want to share with you. The first thing is this: take this link right here. I think it's like up there in the YouTube thing. Take that link and send it to your friends. We would love for them to join us and participate with us in service. The second thing is this: if you've not been connected with us, go ahead and text JF Youth at 88202 to stay connected with us and everything that's going on. And the last thing is this: we've got leaders in the chat, which is over here. So go ahead and chat with us. It's gonna be really, really fun. And the last thing is this: I wanna encourage you, don't just be spectators, but be participators as we get ready to go into worship.
Hey everyone, I'm so excited to be worshiping with you tonight. Why don't you stand and join us wherever you're at? No reason.
Jesus followers to another Sunday night service. You're probably wondering, why is it on me today? The answer is, I am the host. Thank you, Lord.
Of what?
Oh, yes. Let me sing the tune to you. I've always wanted to do this. Because it's host. Oh, wait, hold on.
Whoa, Nelly.
Don't edit that out.
Yeah, leave it.
One more time.
That's fine.
Go ahead.
You know what? Just cue the ring of hot seat, okay?
Hot seat!
But before we get started, I need to take my stuff out. So today I've got this handy dandy blender.
Oh Lord.
That has not been washed.
No, yeah.
That mug is musty.
Okay.
Nasty.
That thing's musty,
bro.
Can we
bring the stuff? Oh my gosh. So today with me, I have a blender and stuff. It says happy birthday because I got a gift for the
both
of you.
That's so ghetto.
I'm so excited. Okay, so what we're gonna play today, here's what I realized, is that the both of y'all have grew up at The Rock since The Rock started.
Okay.
So why not play a little Rock trivia?
Oh.
Rock trivia, okay?
Good.
So here's the catch. I have stuff in here, you guys can't know what it is. You just have to choose a cup. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna ask you a question.
Okay.
If you get the question right, then you don't have to put any of this in the blender. If you get it wrong, then one cup goes in the blender. Loser.
That smells
fishy.
Like.
Ew, yeah. Anyways, loser, whoever gets the most wrong has to drink.
Oh, there's a chance.
Wait.
So if you win.
If you win, you don't have to drink it.
Got it.
So you have to.
Aaron was just a small fry.
You have to win. Okay.
That smells
so
like
because
tuna.
Pastor Luke, yep. Because Pastor Luke is new to hot seat. I'm volunteering him to go.
I don't even get a rock, paper, scissors.
No.
No. Shambo for you, my friend.
No, whatever that is.
Let me quote Justin Timberlake. Right. What goes around comes around.
Here we go. I have the mic and the hot seat host. All right, ready? Question number one. We're gonna start easy. Again, this is rock trivia. You have to know this, ready? First question is this. What are the two scriptures that are posted on the wall in worship center?
Luke 6, 46 to 47, which is whoever comes to me, hears my sayings and does them. I will show you whom he's like. He's like a man who built his house on the rock, dug deep, laid the foundation.
Wow.
That one, and then Hebrews 13, 8. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, forever.
Ding, ding, ding. You don't have to put anything in the handy dandy.
Praise the Lord.
All right, Aaron, you ready?
Give him a good one.
We're gonna start.
Pastor Carl's middle name is.
Remember, we're gonna start easy. Ready? What year did The Rock start?
2000.
Correct. All right.
Technically.
No.
Almost.
2000. Correct.
The word of the Lord came in 99.
Here we go.
Yeah.
And that's when the Lord birthed.
We're tuning this up a bit, okay?
Tuning it up?
Yeah, whatever.
You mean turning?
No, I'm the host. It's my rodeo here.
English words is hard, aren't they, Nicole?
I'm the host. All right, since you're the youth pastor, I thought I'd throw in a little youth question here.
I'm sweating.
What was the first youth album called that we released? Yeah, you should.
Probably
should. Today. Yeah, should we give him 5 seconds?
Just.
I think three is cool.
Three, two.
Honestly.
Oh, rising up.
Dang!
Yes!
You got it right. I just have a feeling that we're giving you too much time. Too much time.
No, that's fine.
Okay, Aaron.
Thank you.
What does OSL stand for?
Oh,
Operation.
Correct! Ding, ding.
That is stupid.
Ding!
Luke!
Pastor Luke!
Like this.
No, I'm fair and square. Okay. I'm fair and square, square is fair, whatever that meant. Okay, ready? What record label did The Rock sign with? I just feel like time is up! No! One wrong! Alright!
Yeah.
We got 6 cups, but I'm gonna put the water just to make it a little
Let the dirt rise.
Alright! Yeah, we've got one, two, we have got six options.
Give me that top right.
This one?
No, that's bottom
this
right,
one. This one, this, right. This one. We got, oh.
What did he get?
We got tuna.
Yes! Yes, I hope you eat.
Delicious.
But then again, this is
delicious.
You have a shot.
I'm getting a little excited. I think this is.
Celebrate early.
Okay, Aaron. Here we go.
So bad.
Ready, Aaron?
Sure, that's tuna.
Yeah, I think. Sure, we bought it at Walmart, like, so you never know. Aaron.
In a box.
Which pastor's dad was a rock star?
Which pastor's dad
was a rock star?
Was a rock star.
Correct.
Say Pastor.
Wrong!
Oh, yes! Pastor Tristan!
Pastor Tristan!
Nice!
Alright, Aaron. This is out of the way, but which. Which cup?
Let's go with the back left one.
This one?
Yeah.
All right, it's fine. We just got some hot Cheetos here.
Oh, not bad.
No, I like a little hot Cheeto tuna sandwich.
A little hot Cheeto tuna.
Here. Okay.
Disgusting in your mouth and disgusting coming out. That's what that is. Okay.
All right, Pastor Luke.
Can you look at the Cheeto exploding?
Ready for this. For Pastor Jerry's 50th birthday, we dropped a music video. Which three people starred in that music video?
Pastor Tammy Sefko, Pastor Eric Diaz, and Pastor Rick Guerra.
Jerry!
5-0 Jerry.
5-0 Jerry.
This is my Bible.
5-0 Jerry.
This is my Bible.
You got it!
Unfortunately, I was the tech director. So.
Oh, bust. All right, Aaron, here we go. Ready for this?
Yes.
What is Pastor Carl's most famous Wednesday night message?
Most famous
Wednesday night message.
You don't know this?
Moses and me.
Oh, my dang! God. I was going to say, if you don't know this, you're fired.
How? Wow! All right.
You're seriously
Luke. Getting me. Okay.
Here we go. All right. What speaker spoke when there was an earthquake at the Rock Forum?
I'm not sure if you can hear it now. Now, this could be a trying to get me on a technicality. Are you talking about who was on stage?
No, what speaker spoke? Yep.
What? Okay, well, the speaker who spoke was Chad Beach. The person who was on the stage.
Dang, what in
the person
world?
On the stage was Shane Jackson.
Dang, Pastor Luke is not drinking this. Aaron, here we go. Ready for this?
Oh, yeah.
This one, really simple. Ready? What was level 4 called? Before, when it was called Operation Attack, before level 4.
What was it called before?
Before level four.
So before OSL, before it was OSL, it was called Operation Attack. What was the name of level 4 before we switched it to level 4?
Air Force?
Dang!
Oh, wow.
Dang, I didn't think so.
Dang,
they're doing real good.
Like,
this hosting thing may not
basic
be for me.
Basic training.
I should ask.
Boot camp. CIA. Right, Air Force Special Ops.
Here we go. We've got a few more, guys. What was the first kids musical?
Like the first ever?
The first.
Was it about Jonah?
Wrong. The best present of all. Amazing.
I would never.
Please.
Never.
Choose one.
Top middle.
What is it?
Oh my gosh. I hate this stuff. It's mustard.
Oh. I was like, no, that isn't. That's Justice's diaper. That's what that is.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
I've seen that mess.
Here we go, Aaron. Here we go. We just got three more questions. Right now, Luke is losing. Aaron, you are winning.
I am.
Here we go, Aaron.
Keep winning.
Shh.
Keep winning.
Aaron, this one's really easy. Okay. Where is Pastor Kimberly from?
Columbia.
Correct.
You are stacking the deck, and you will pick.
I am reading.
This is my week.
So you gotta take it for, see, you gotta take an L sometimes before you take the dub. You feel me? Yeah, I took my L, I'm ready for the dub.
Pastor Luke. This one's really easy. You should know this. Who was a flower girl in Pastor David's wedding?
Oh, was it Hannah?
Correct!
Yes!
Yes! His sister!
My sister!
Okay, all you gotta do is get this right. If you get this right, Pastor Luke loses. If you get this wrong, we have to go to a bonus round question. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, right here.
Okay, here it is, ready. Okay, this should be really, really, really good. Okay, what year was the worship center established?
I'm gonna say.
No! Oh! 2009.
I knew that!
Aaron!
I bet you did.
Okay, please choose one.
Bottom left.
Let's go.
Bottom left.
Top left.
Top left. Oh, yeah, this is also nasty. Good luck. There's a little mayo here. I know. Grody, huh? Y'all should really choose this one. Donut. Okay.
What was that?
Here it is. Here's how we're gonna play the bonus round, okay? The first person to know the answer, I'm just gonna ask the both of you. Okay? So bonus question. First person to know the answer is the winner. Are y'all ready? Because we're tied here. I've got two bonus answers just in case you don't know the first one. What was the last song we sang at the worship center before coronavirus?
I want to see a victory.
Wrong!
I don't even remember what the song is called. The Surrounded.
Wrong!
Ugh, what is it?
Overcoming Faith.
Oh.
Okay, this this one is really easy, so please, whoever yells at first, this is the winner. Right here, this is easy. All three of us grew up at The Rock, right? But our parents went to another church.
Valley Community Church in El Monte.
Should have been the question!
Let's go! Let's go!
Oh my
god!
Yeah. It
doesn't matter! I got it right first.
I wasn't even.
He's right. Well, the loser!
That's not even fair!
Of today's hot seat is Aaron himself.
Yes! This is the best game ever. Great job, Nicole.
Oh my gosh. Okay, we'll be right back as we go ahead and blend this and Aaron takes a sip of whatever is in the blender. They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine. You just can't.
Oh, let's go. Okay, here's what I propose.
No.
Oh my god.
You about to have some. You about to have a taste of total, my friend.
Here we go.
Pour him what he needs to drink.
Okay.
Like pour just a sip.
That's good.
Pour me a sip.
That is great.
Oh man.
I'm not even smelling it.
Here we go. It's like Jamba Juice.
I can't smell it. I can't.
Oh my god.
Stop it. Pour it.
Okay.
Yeah, that I agree to that.
What do you mean?
Okay, bottoms up, my friend.
What do you mean?
That's not a lot.
Someone close this. It smells so bad.
Okay, Aaron. Sure. Bottoms up, my friend. And when you're done, look straight at that camera.
Should you get a trash can?
Ha! Okay, ready?
Yeah.
All right, on three. One.
I love you guys.
Two, three. Go.
Get him water.
Oh, wow. That was impressive.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh!
Oh! Oh, my God. guys.
Dude,
I'm so
sorry. I thought you were gonna hit the camera with your vomit.
Oh!
Oh, that's
you just burp.
I'm so sorry.
I straight up would have thought that was. Wow.
Oh, wow. Well.
Can I have a dime, please? I can't. Oh, that's not. That doesn't feel right.
I'm so sorry. Okay, guys.
Can we see the replay? Of the almost throw up please, really please. Quick.
Oh! Oh!
Well, guys, thank you so much for joining us on this week.
Oh, 2 seconds to go down the throw.
Let's see you at announcements. Love you.
Hey, what's going on, Jesus followers? Before we get into some more worship, I just got a couple announcements for you guys. My first announcement is Zoomies. We got Zoomies every single week on Thursdays at 7 p.m. And if you haven't done it already, joined it, you can join by texting Zoomies to 88202 and get signed up that way. My second announcement for you guys is we got Daily Bread every single day. We got a video up at 10 a.m. This is a great way for us to get into the Word together and for us to seek God in a new way. So again, 10 a.m. every day, we got Daily Bread for you guys. Without further ado, let's get into some worship.
As we worship together, we're going to introduce a new song called Move Your Heart. This song is about surrendering everything to the Lord and just wanting to move His heart. So right where you're at, would you just lift your hands and would you just surrender to Jesus everything that you have? Oh, we surrender. Come on, let's sing this out. Sing Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus. Precious Lord, none on the earth or heavens above, that I have found more beautiful, you are my treasure, my great reward. I just want I just wanna stand in awe and pour my love on you, no matter how much the cost. I freely give it all to you. Come on, let's sing Jesus, my offering. Jesus, yeah.
Oh, well, thank God for a good time in worship, a good time in His presence, and we're going to continue in that right now. Welcome, Jesus followers, to our May 3rd service. We're so excited to get into the Word with you. I know that I'm really looking forward to a time when we can be together again, but we're going to get into the Word. We're going to dive in. I just encourage you to open up your hearts, open up your Bibles, get your notes out, and let's really engage with this time. I know that for myself, that right now when I'm on screens more than ever, doing whatever it is, Zoom calls or Instagram, YouTube, that I have to really purpose my heart to engage with God. And so make sure you really engage with God in this time. Let Him speak to you personally. And we're going to get right into it. We're in this series called In the Waiting. And I'm really excited for this because we've had some really good first couple messages here. I hope that you're staying in tune with what's going on YouTube, and we're putting out a lot of good stuff for you. But this message number three here is called this, In God's Presence. In God's Presence. When we are in this season of waiting, when we're in this season of not knowing exactly what's going to happen next, we have to know that in this season of waiting, that God wants to be with us. See, it's one thing to know the principles of God. It's another thing to know the person of God. It's another thing to know the person of God. And we've talked about two things already. We've talked about finding the sweet spot, that we don't want to get ahead of God. We don't want to be behind God. We want to be with God in the sweet spot. We've also talked about how timing is everything, that when we're in the presence of God, that we have to understand that God's timing is not necessarily ours. But I want to talk to you about what I believe is the key to waiting on God. And the biggest benefit of waiting on God is God's presence. And so I want to remind us of our foundational scripture for this. In Isaiah 40, 31, it says this, "But those who wait upon God get fresh strength. They spread their wings and soar like eagles. They run and don't get tired. They walk and they don't lag behind." And I want to remind you what this word waiting means. It doesn't mean a passive waiting. It doesn't mean just a sitting back and just whatever, trying to pass the time. It means this. It means to look eagerly for, to hope for, and to expect. But it also has this other definition. It means to bind together, almost like ropes. And during this season, when we're waiting on the Lord, we need to bind our life together with Him, not with our favorite YouTuber, not with the people that we follow on Instagram, not even with our friends, but the most important person that we could lock our lives in together with is Jesus Himself. And I've said a couple of quotes that I really believe are foundational for this, but we've got to remember that who you're with is more important than where you're going or what you're doing. And the people you're with are more important than the destination and the activity. Now, in this season of time, I can guarantee that you feel the same way that I do, that, man, I'm over the Zoom calls. I'm over the Instagram lives. I enjoy being able to connect with everybody via technology. But the reality is this, that I am excited to be with people, to be with you guys, to be able to give you a high five and to say hello and to hug you and all those kinds of things, because there's nothing like being in the presence of somebody else, right? We know that all these Zoom calls, okay, that's great. I can see this version of you, but it's different when you're together. It's different when you're sitting on the couch. It's different when you're reacting to the joke that somebody else said, or you're able to be in close proximity. And I believe this, that a lot of Christians live in a relationship with God that's like a Zoom relationship. That when God, you know, when you feel like you've got to answer the call or you've got to hop on with God, that now you just see this one side of Him. But God wants to be someone that He wants you to be in His presence. He wants you to spend time with Him. He wants to spend time with you. It's an invitation that we answer the call to. And when we're talking about in the waiting, when we're talking about this waiting season, I want to teach you how to wait on God and to be in His presence. There's this amazing story in Exodus chapter 33, where this man Moses, who is a man who really the Bible says there was no one more humble than Moses. There was no one like Moses in the Bible. And Moses was a man who the children of Israel, knew about God. Moses knew God and his ways. And in our relationship with God, we want to be more like Moses, who knows God, who goes and meets with God. And in this chapter, Exodus 33, I encourage you to read the whole chapter, but this thing happens where the children of Israel, basically they've dishonored God over and over and over. And God promised them to go into this place called the Promised Land, where he says it was an abundant land. It was a blessed land. It was a land flowing with milk and honey. When I was a little kid, I used to think, like, that's a weird river. Milk and honey, okay? Like, were they really big on cereal? No. Milk represents cows, praise God, beef. And honey represents bees, which would make plants and things more fruitful because they would pollinate and such. And so in Exodus 33, they've rebelled over and over. And God says this to the children of Israel. He says, listen, I'm going to send you guys into the Promised Land. Basically, you've broken my heart over and over and over. And I'm going to send you guys in. I'm going to send an angel ahead of you to take all your enemies out, but I'm not going to go with you. But Moses contends with God and comes back, and he's like, God, I don't want a life like that. I want to be close with you. I want you to be close with us. Don't send us into the Promised Land without your presence. So let's look here at Exodus 33, and I'm going to read to you verses 12 through 16. It says right here, one day Moses said to the Lord, you have been telling me, take these people up to the Promised Land, but you haven't told me whom you will send with me. You have told me, I know you by name. I look favorably on you. If it's true that you look favorably on me, let me know your ways so I understand more fully and continue to enjoy your favor. And remember, he says this, remember that this nation is your own special people. The Lord replied, I will personally go with you, Moses. I will give you rest. Everything will be fine for you. Then Moses said, if you don't personally go with us, let this be our prayer, guys. If you don't personally go with us, don't make us leave this place. How will anyone know that you look favorably on me and your people, if you don't go with us? For your presence among us sets your people and me apart from all other people on the earth. Guys, that last verse is the key. Your presence, God's presence, sets you apart from everyone else on this earth. Because when God is with you, things happen. When God is with you, you have more peace than everyone else. When God is with you, you're not depressed. When God is with you, you have joy, because that's what the presence of God does. Now, I want to encourage you this, and write this down as you're taking notes. I want you to move forward from a principle-based relationship with God to a presence-based relationship with God. Now, a lot of people, they first learn about God like this. They learn about God's principles, right? So they learn things like, okay, I understand that there are some things that we shouldn't do, right? We shouldn't steal. You know, a lot of people talk about the Ten Commandments or things like that. We shouldn't steal. We shouldn't lie. We shouldn't, have lust in our heart, those kinds of things. So they learn the principles of God, but some people never add God's presence on top of his principles. See, because when you learn God's principles, you really learn the wisdom of God about this world. You learn maybe some of the do's and the don'ts. You learn maybe about giving, about sowing and reaping and those kinds of things. And when you're in the Bible, You're learning the principles of God. But I want to encourage you that the Bible says in John chapter 1 that Jesus is the Word, that he is the Word. And when you move past I'm not saying to ignore the principles of God. I'm saying be in the presence of God that acts as the add-on, the addition to his principles, that when you interact with the person of God, that he's not just someone out there or someone that Pastor Luke or Pastor Nicole knows, but this is someone that you know. You now have another level of relationship with God. If there was one goal I had as a youth pastor, it's that you would know the person and the presence of Jesus himself, that you would know God through a relationship with the Father, through Jesus, and through the Holy Spirit. That would be my one goal for you. And I want to encourage you that this is not something that is not
outside of our own human nature. Think about this. When I was dating Kayla, when we would go on dates, and most often we would go to Panera. Now, this just shows how much I love Kayla, because I would never go to Panera before. She loved soup and bread. Those two things were not always my favorites, but I would go to the place that she liked because I wanted to go on a date with her. I wanted to impress her. I wanted to spend time with her, right? So I knew who she was from the outside. I knew the principles of what she liked. I knew the things that about her, but I didn't know her. But think about this, when I came into a fullness of relationship with her when we got married, now I don't have to go drop her off at her house every night after the date. Now we go home together. Now I know her at another level, because now her presence, think about it, her presence is not taken away from me. See, I want to encourage you, don't just go on a date with God and leave him outside of your life. Invite him in and let his presence be with you all the time. I know as you're watching this, you're being stirred to know there's more of a relationship with God that you can have. And I want to show you this too. You know, a lot of people come to God and they pray about things that happen in their life or that they're concerned about happening, like maybe where you're going to go to college and all this stuff. But you're not going to find your purpose outside of God's presence. You're not going to find your purpose outside of God's presence. In Matthew 28, the last three verses of the entire book of Matthew, we have this commission from God that it's popularly known as the Great Commission, that when Jesus is leaving the earth, he says, these are his last words. Now think about it, Jesus' last words here on earth, and think about how intentional he is with his last words. He says this in Matthew 28, 18 through 20, and I'm reading in the New Living. He says this, Jesus came and told his disciples, I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. Therefore, listen to this, go and make disciples. What's he saying? Replicate yourself. Go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And then listen to this, the very last thing he says, and be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Are you reading this? The very last thing Jesus says is he talks about his presence. He says, I'm with you always. Now we know that in the book of Acts, as we go forward, Jesus sends the Holy Spirit, which is God, the third person of the Trinity. And the Holy Spirit has no physical body, so he can live on the inside of us. This is God living with us, his presence with us. And Jesus says, I am with you always. So notice in this three verse portion here, he gives the disciples purpose. He gives you and me a purpose. Go make disciples of all the nations. It doesn't matter if you're a doctor, if you're a painter, or if you're a pastor. Your commission is to make disciples of all the nations. That is your assignment on this earth. But notice, he does not give purpose without his presence. He says, I'm commissioning you to make disciples, and I'm going to be with you always. What a good God who doesn't just send us out on assignment, but he goes with us. See, Moses had an understanding. I don't want to go fulfill my purpose without the presence of God. And I want to encourage you that you don't just find your purpose in his presence, but you fulfill your purpose in his presence. Not only do you just receive the assignment, but you're able to walk it out with the presence of God. And some of you are like, well, how do I do this? How do I spend time in the presence of God? What I've noticed is this, that when you spend time in God's presence in the secret place, you learn how to keep him in the public place. Woo, this is so good. When you learn how to spend time with God in his presence in the secret place, you learn how to keep him with you in the public place. See, even just yesterday, I was working and I was doing my normal tasks. And as I'm working, God just a couple of times, actually it was like three or four times, said, you know, call this person, talk to this person. And I had some God conversations just because I knew God's presence is with me and he was leading me to do something. And God moved through me. It can be the same thing with you. God is not a respecter of persons, meaning he will not do something for someone else that he would not do for you. God is so good. And I want to remind you even of the time where Jesus in the early chapters of Matthew, where he shows up on the scene and you know, he gets baptized in the Jordan. You would remember this, that the Bible says that the Holy Spirit came down on him like a dove. A lot of people, you know, give the Holy Spirit as the symbol of a dove, but it says like a dove, and he rested on Jesus. And I think that's just such a great imagery for us, that we need to know that God wants to rest on us just like that dove. You know, you might feel like, yeah, well, God will just stay on me anytime. But, you know, doves are not an animal that will just chill on your shoulder no matter what you do. There's got to be a sensitivity. There's got to be a yieldedness of your life over to God. You can't just, you know, live a sinful life, live crazy, live all, you know, your own will all the time. And that dove, in the sense, the Holy Spirit rest on you. But we've got to be sensitive to him. We've got to be kind to others. We've got to be open to what God says to us in order for his presence to rest on us. And even just to be practical, just the other day, I was in my home and I was washing dishes. I was literally washing the dishes. I threw my AirPods in and I just started to worship God. And I, just out of the sincerity of my heart, I was just worshiping him with no agenda. And I gotta tell you, like, the presence of God came all over me. I just started to bawl. I was like overcome with just joy and peace. And it was just a normal moment of life, that you don't have to be in this crazy, holy moment. But anytime throughout the day, you can, this is how I would call it, you can turn aside into the presence of God. And I wanna encourage you that the Holy Spirit, that God's Spirit himself, he's in you for you. He's in you for you. That when he comes to fill you, he's in you for your peace, for your joy, for that sense of love, of the love of God that comes on you. He's in you for you, but he comes on you for others. The Holy Spirit's in you for you, but he comes on you for others. And the more he's in you, the more he gets on you for others. I've noticed this, that when I'm spending time with God, that God's situations, they attract themselves to me. Now in the book of Acts, there's some amazing stories here where Peter is walking down the street and people are so aware that God is on Peter that as he's walking, his shadow heals people. That people are like blind and paralyzed and they're just sitting on the street hoping that Peter will pass by them and his shadow heals them. You guys, we're not making this stuff up. This is not superhero stuff. This is real human beings, that God was so on them that his shadow healed people. Not only that, Paul, later on in Acts chapter 19, there were napkins that were taken. Paul is eating, guys. He's wiping his mouth. And someone's like, yo, God is so on Paul, I'm going to take his napkin. And people were healed. Demons were cast out because of the napkin. Now, does that mean there's something, you know, like holy about the napkin? No, there's something about the presence of God that is so powerful that when it's put in the right situation, it will bring freedom and breakthrough to people. Those people were so with God that the things that they touched brought deliverance to other people. God is in you for you, but he's on you for others. And I want to, lastly, as I bring it home here, I want to talk about the rewards of being in the presence of God. Hebrews 11, verse 6 says this: it's impossible to please God without faith. Anyone who wants to come to him must believe two things. One, that he exists, and that he rewards those who sincerely seek him, or as we're talking about it, sincerely wait on him. Now, literally this morning, as I'm preparing and finishing this message, Zion, my two-year-old, comes out. And I realized as I was writing this, as a father, I do this all the time. I bait my kids with rewards to be with me. My little one, he has seen Justice, our newborn, you know, eating from a bottle and such. And so he comes up to me all the time now and he goes, he likes milk. And he goes, Dad, I want milk in a bottle. I want milk in a bottle. And that's exactly how he says it, right? He's like, Daddy, I want milk in a bottle. And this morning he came up to me, he said the same thing. And I said, okay, you can have milk, but you got to come up here and give me hug and kiss first. And he hopped up on my lap. He put his arms around me. He goes, hug and kiss. And he gives me hug and kiss. And I just thought, like, this is just the heart of a dad, just to go, like, I want you to be close to me and I'll incentivize you to do it. You guys have no idea. But the more you spend time with God, I promise you, he will bless you. And I'm not just talking about intangible things like peace and joy, though you will find those things in him. But I guarantee you, things are going to come into your life that are going to bless you. And you're going to go, wow, why did that happen? And God is going to remind you, you've been spending time with me. anyone who comes, put that verse back up on the screen. Anyone who comes to God must believe, one, that he exists, but two, that he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. And I believe that God rewards us because he wants us close. He wants us to know, like, I'm rewarding you. Stay close to me. Stay close to me. The way you get blessed is by staying close. I want to show you a couple other scriptures before we close here. Psalm 16:11 says this, "You will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore." The cure to depression is being in the presence of God. In your presence is fullness of joy. Not fake joy, not temporary joy, fullness of joy. Isaiah 26:3 in New Living says this, "You will keep him in perfect peace, all who trust in you, whose thoughts are fixed on you." See, you can't have your thoughts fixed on God when you're not regularly in his presence, when you're not with him, when you're not spending time with him. And lastly, Matthew 6:6 says this, "When you pray, go away by yourself, shut the door behind you, and pray to your Father in private. Then your Father, who sees everything, will reward you." Guys, when we're spending time with God, when we're in this season of waiting, I pray that the one discipline you walk out of this season with is shutting your door. And I believe if Jesus was writing this scripture in this day, Jesus would say, shut your door, turn off your computer, put your phone on airplane mode, and give it to your mama and tell her, don't let me out of this room for 30 minutes until I'm spending time with God. Spend time with God, reading the Bible, worshiping him. Just no agenda other than to be with God. And in this season of waiting, I encourage you to learn to grow in your relationship in being in God's presence. And I promise you that breakthroughs will come in your life. I know that some of you watching this right now, just God's telling me right now that you feel down, you feel depressed, you feel like when you walk throughout your day, there's a fogginess, like your mind, you can't think clearly. And I know this, that if you will learn how to get into the presence of God, you don't have to be a pastor, you don't have to be a preacher, you don't have to be a Bible college student to get into the presence of God. And so here's what we're doing. Right now, there's gonna be a link connected to this video. At the end of this video, at the end, as we conclude service, you can click on a worship session that our worship team did. And it's just gonna be an extended time. If you're feeling a stir to go into the presence of God right now, you can click this link as we're finishing, not yet, as we're finishing, and you can go right into a time of worship. And I would encourage you just to let it play, to set the distractions aside and to just say, God, I'm gonna spend time with you. And as you watch our worship team lead and just spend time in God's presence, that you would learn how to spend time in God's presence too. So that's going to come up, and that link is just going to stay here. But we encourage you guys to keep engaging with our YouTube channel. Subscribe. Remember, we've got daily bread that you guys can get into a chapter every single day with us. And don't miss out on Zoomies every single Thursday night. We love you guys. If you're going to jump into the presence of God right now, go ahead and click that link. But other than that, we love you guys so much. Have a great rest of your week.